In this video, we're going to see some shortcuts that we can use in the editor to make it easier to write and edit code. The most useful shortcut to help us focus on our code is Shift-Command-F12, or Control-Shift-F12, to hide all the windows and have the editor take the full space available. Now let's look at some editor shortcuts. We can use Command and Backspace on macOS, or Control and Y on Windows and Linux, to delete the current line. We can cut a line, placing it onto the clipboard, by pressing Command and X, or Control and X, without selecting or highlighting anything. This can save us a few keystrokes. Obviously, we can paste this with Command V or Control V, like in any application. We can move a statement up using Shift Command and Up, or Control Shift and Up. We'll see more of this in a minute. Like cut, we can also copy a whole line with Command C or Control C without having to highlight it first. And obviously we can paste this too. In this particular case, it might be more useful to duplicate the line instead with Command D or Control D. As we saw earlier, we can move a statement up. Moving a statement moves the Java statement as a whole. So if we apply this to the line with a variable declaration, it will move the whole statement, in this case the whole multi-line string declaration. The move is context sensitive, so in this case the IDE won't let us move it up any further, so we can't move it out of the method. Use Shift Command and Down, or Control Shift and Down arrow to move it down. If we want to move just a line, or if we want to move something without worrying so much about the context we're moving it into or out of, we can move a line up with Alt, Shift and Up. This lets us move this line anywhere. If we select more than one line and use the shortcut, it will move all the highlighted lines. One of the simplest but most useful editor features is if we create a line break in the middle of a declared string, IntelliJ IDEA will automatically close off the string on the line above, add a plus for concatenation, and reopen the string on the line below. To join the lines together, we use Ctrl, Shift, and J. This is extremely helpful for formatting multi-line strings and for laying out block comments. We saw that pressing Enter splits the line and puts our caret on the new line. We can also use Command and Enter, or Control and Enter, to split the line but keep our caret on the current line. You may have seen this in one of our other screencasts. We can use Alt and Up, or Ctrl and W to extend our selection to include ever-increasing valid blocks of code. We can use Alt and Down, or Ctrl, Shift and W to decrease the selection back to where we started. Column selection mode is a useful tool for manipulating code or text. We can turn it on by using Find Action or Search Everywhere to look for it, or use the shortcut Shift Command 8 or Shift Alt and Insert. Once we're in column selection mode, we can create carats in a column above or below where we are. This can be useful for working with lists or other linear formats. We can use the same shortcut again, or Find Action or Search Everywhere, to toggle off column selection mode. If we need to place multiple carats in specific places, we can hold down Alt and Shift and click where we want the next carat to be. As we type, each carat will output the same thing. To get back to our original caret, we just have to press Escape. As well as column select mode, we can also clone our caret above or below where we are. Press Alt and then Alt a second time, but this time keep holding down Alt. Then press Down to create another caret directly below. Again, this is useful for column-based formatting or edits. Press Escape to go back to one caret. We can tap Alt twice, holding down the Alt on the second time, and press the up arrow to clone the caret to the line above. We're probably used to using Command F or Control F to find something, but we can also use Command G or F3 to find the next occurrence of the word currently at the caret and move to it. Alternatively, we can use Control Command G or Control Alt Shift and J to select all instances of the current word. Sometimes we want to turn something into a string value. We don't have to move the caret to the start of the word, type an opening quote, move to the end and type a closing quote. We just have to highlight the text we want to enclose in quotes and then type the quote. This also works for all types of brackets. The quotes or brackets will be placed directly outside the highlighted text. Finally, did you know that IntelliJ IDEA keeps a record of everything that was copied inside the IDE? We can paste an item that we've copied in the past by using Shift, Command and V or Control, Shift and V. We can see all the items we've copied or cut in the past. We can use the keyboard to navigate these items, and we can even copy sections of the copied code for later use. You might notice from this example that the editor and other sections of IntelliJ IDEA support emojis. It's also useful to note that from the history window, we don't have to use the arrow keys to move all the way down to the item we want. We can type the number next to the history item we want to paste, for example, 4. That's a small selection of shortcuts to help us while writing code or text in the IntelliJ IDEA editor. Thanks for watching.